Good day, YouTubers. MotoMerica here. So hey, today we're back in the Moto Garage, and we're gonna do some customization to the Suzuki GSXS1000F. Today all we're gonna do is something simple. Simple's good sometimes, right? We're gonna replace the factory bar end sliders on this Suzuki with these new custom Puig high-tech parts bar end sliders. So the first thing we have to do for this project is to remove these factory end bar sliders, right? So you'll notice on the Suzuki, it's a Phillips head screw. So we're gonna need one of these. Let's get busy. All we gotta do is loosen this, right? Not too hard. Squeaking, that's great. And that's pretty simple. Let's take it out, see what we got. Oh man, look at that. So this is how the factory Suzuki bar end sliders held in. It's this long contraption. It looks like when you tighten that screw down, it smashes and expands these rubber things, rubber bushings, I guess. So it fills a tube in the handlebar. Ah, that's pretty simple. Let's get busy. All right, guys, so here's the parts kit that came with the package. I just bought this off of one of the online retailers. You know who they are. So it comes with a selection of stainless hardware. And it looks like, as you can see from our stock device here, we're gonna need this long one. I'm not sure what all these short ones are for, but these two long ones we'll use to replace this factory thing. And it comes with all these colored rings, which are pretty cool, because I'm gonna use red. So I already have enough blue on that bike. I want some red. So it comes with two red, two of everything. Two blue. That's how they look. Comes with black, silver, and this kind of a gold color. I mean, it's kind of a orangey gold, but it is what it is. The silver are pretty cool. If you got that all blacked out bike, there's your black ones. So that's the kit. So here's my assembly. That's how it's going to look with the stainless bolt or screw, stainless screw in there. And we're going to install that. The reason I'm doing this, I think, adds a little bit of coolness to the bike. Just a simple mod. I think these were like, I don't know, less than $50. But I'm not sure on that, so shop around. My other problem is on the other side of my bike. My bike did fall over once on the way down from the bike lift, and it did scratch up the one on the right side of the bike. So replacing it gets rid of the scratches too, so that'll make me happy. You feel stupid when you drop your bike, right? Shit happens. Anyway, I'm gonna use the red ones. That's how it looks. Okay, let's get busy. Okay guys, back at the bike side. So you can see, I removed this Phillips screw we took out of there. Remember, that was part of that assembly. And all I did was I put our new piece and the new hex screw inside there, and it's kinda ready to go. Pretty simple, right? So let's get rid of that. And this Puig, or Puig, however you say that, is a 5mm. So that that fits in there like that, and we're just gonna get that started so it starts to squish that stuff. And I'm thinking, too much. We get that in there. I want that name up. There we go. Tighten that. Get the other end down there. Get it nice and tight. Yeah, that's good. Now I'm assuming I could put some blue Loctite on there if it starts to come loose. I don't think it will, because that whole you know, compressing the rubber thing idea, but we'll see. If they get loose, I'll take them off and I'll put blue Loctite on there and do it again. Not a big deal. I think that looks fantastic. I can't wait to do the other side. One thing to note, these are not quite as heavy as the factory bar ends. So I don't know if it's going to increase the vibration or what, but we'll see. But they're about half as heavy as the factory. But they look awesome, right? Look at that red on there with the blue. Woo! Yeah. Other side, here we come. All right, guys, here we are on the right side of the bike. And you can see where what I was talking about. This is all scuffed up here and feels all nasty and sharp. So let's get rid of that old thing. So again, I already loosened it, obviously, but here's the screw thing. You don't need that. That's done. We're done with that, right? Let's get rid of that. Pull this baby out. Look at that. That's a pretty cool assembly compared to some of the other bikes. You know, they have that like expanding thing. Suzuki did their homework here. So anyway, let's replace that with the new one again. All right, guys. So again, what I did was I assembled the new piece. Right? Look at that. Woo! Sexy! So I got rid of the screw we took out, Phillips. Got rid of that. Don't need that anymore. Off she goes. So here's our new assembly. Again, this is 5 millimeters. So that's this. And we're gonna shove it in place. And I got it too tight. Let's loosen that a bit. Shove it in there. Tighten her up. Get the crank side going. There we go. Side two completed. That looks awesome, right? Look at that. It actually matches my GSXS cover I replaced with the red color. Look at that. See that? It's awesome. All right, guys, we are done with that project. The whole thing took less than 15, 20 minutes, even with filming. That's how she looks from the front of the Suzuki GSXS1000F. Looks pretty cool. Love the red on there. Let's take it around the side here. There's the front view. Got the sun going in the background. Isn't that pretty? And hey, here's one more view in case you didn't see it close up. Very nice. Loving that. For the price, it's an easy mod. Anybody can do it. You get great color options. Very simple and easy to put on. So anyways, guys, I do appreciate you watching my videos. Do hit the like button if you can, and subscribe to my channel to get notified when I have new videos. But this project is done, and I am happy. Looks great. You guys have a safe ride. Be good. Have fun. See you later.